First, I want to thank God for allowing me to be here today with you all. I never thought that the first time I'd be speaking in here would also be the last time. Such is life, you know? I almost decided not to speak today and just leave a speech for public record. But then I thought about how many people back home who have been inspired by my journey and will never hear their voices heard in these halls. It's then when I realized that I had to represent. Thank you to my colleagues that made sure that I was up here today in front of you all. I haven't been here long enough to talk about what I've done, but I can talk about where I'm from. I was raised in a blended household in a neighborhood in Pittsburgh called Homewood, a place where many people avoid traveling through at all costs, a place that's usually in the news headlines only when something bad happens. However, that place birthed me. It helped shape me. A place that fostered my grit, resolve, and resilience. My mother worked for the City of Pittsburgh Water Department, reading water meters all over Pittsburgh's hilly terrain. Every day after work, she'd come back to Homewood and work with my stepfather on our family's business. My stepfather is a Vietnam War veteran, a former member of the Black Panther Party, and a formerly incarcerated person. Together, they created a community organization whose first mission was to curb gang violence in the early and mid-90s. Our living room served as the first office, hosting healing circles for parents that lost their children to violence, Sunday dinners, and community meetings in that living room. Service to the community is in my blood. I have played my part, and I will play my next part with the same honesty, respect, excellence, and pride that I've brought to this role. This isn't goodbye, though. This is more of a see you later. Thank you for this time, and thank God for this opportunity. Be blessed and remain inspired. Thank you.